Hello everyone and welcome to the pythonvest.com YouTube channel. Today we'll talk about the practical portfolio optimization. So let's assume you have a sum of money and you want to invest into several stocks. You may want to get an optimal split of weights for your investments. Why are you going to do this? A smart portfolio management can reduce the overall risk of portfolio, can increase returns per units of risk, and can reduce losses in the worst case events. We will use the standard library PyPortfolioOpt. You can read the user guide here, or you can check the detailed Colab example. I used a lot of functions from this example. Let's check the plan. We'll start from the preparation works of imports, getting the financial data and built-in pivot tables. Then we will talk about the correlation matrix, the intuition behind the portfolio optimization theory. Then we will see three optimal portfolios with mean volatility, max Sharpe ratio, and mean cVAR or conditional variance portfolios. Then we will see an efficient frontier. And finally, we will find the best discrete allocation of stocks. I also wrote a detailed article on my website, pyinvest.com, with a slightly different setup when you do repetitive short-term trading for 3 days. I manually built all combinations of portfolios and check the portfolio matrix and built a scoring model for those metrics. So let's begin. First, we install YFinance and get usual imports for Pandas, NumPy, and Matplotlib. We will have $2,000 for our experiment here, and these tickers to invest. They are actual tickers that I recently tried to invest in. Here we get the daily prices for the stocks. For example, last day prices is actually 2 day. For today we have 8 different records for the stock values. We also generate a pivot table so that 1 day represents one line and we store only close prices for the stocks. So now with this setup we have 8 different rows which represent time series stats, and we can find the correlations between those time series. Correlations matrix is a matrix like this. It is it has one on the diagonal, so correlation of a stock with itself is always one. It is a symmetrical matrix, so correlation of PA with BUT is the same as BUT with PA. So we are interested in either bottom triangle or upper triangle above the main diagonal. Here we have the bottom triangle, which is colored. It is always good to have different colors or more variation of correlations. So any correlation lies between -1 and 1, and stocks that have a similar correlation, say 0.96, 0.87, is not very good for the purposes of a portfolio diversification, because they tend to move in the same direction, and the optimization algorithm will probably try to mix in other stocks that are loosely correlated with many top performing stocks. So for this set of stocks, probably PTR is the most important one because it's not correlated with many other stocks. So now let's look at the PyPortfolioOpt library. We do install it, check its version. We import some functions, and first we find an expected returns for individual stocks. There are a number of options to find and the expected returns. Here I use CAPM underscore return function. It can be mean historical return or EMA historical return. You can read about it in the library itself. Then we find the covariance matrix. So it's unconstrained parameter, unconstrained matrix for covariance between each set of each pair of stocks. And when we have mu and s, we can build an efficient frontier and calculate the best performing portfolios. We also specify weight bounds between 0 and 1 so that we don't allow short trading with negative weights. We also buy stocks and go long and then sell after some period of time. Let's check what is a minimum volatility portfolio, what is a max Sharpe ratio, and what is a cVAR optimal portfolio. Okay, first, as we remember, it's average returns, expected returns for each stock. They can be slightly different depending on the method of estimation, but here we see that NVIDIA is actually the top performing stock with 30%, 39% annual expected returns. Also, Shopify and BAR top performing stocks. And if we want to optimize portfolio and to reduce its minimum volatility, sometimes the most performing stocks like NVIDIA, they will have weight zero, probably because they bring a lot of volatility with the returns. So the metrics for this portfolio will be expected annual return, that is 16.2%, which is lower than many of the returns for the individual stocks, but it has a low volatility of 8.9% and Sharpe ratio, that is expected annual return divided on annual volatility, which equals to 1.67. Next, if we want to optimize the Sharpe ratio, which is expected return per volatility, we will see slightly different weights. Now, NVIDIA has a weight and BA has a weight. And with this, we are adding the top performing stocks. We are increasing the expected annual return from 16.2 to 22.4%. But the annual volatility is increasing only from 8.9 to 10.7, so that Sharpe ratio actually is increased from 1.67 to 1.91. And in many cases, this portfolio will be treated as the optimal portfolio. And last but not least, portfolio is the one that minimizes the losses in the worst cases. So let's start with the Max Sharpe portfolio weights. We have these weights and calculate for this portfolio the daily returns distribution. So in many cases, daily returns lie between -5% and +5%. And it can be slightly shifted towards left or right, but in most of the cases you will see a bell-shaped distribution curve. Then we find 5% worst cases quantile, so here it is somewhere between -5% and zero, and we take average returns for the worst cases. So we see that the quantile is actually -2.56%, so it is here, and 5% of the worst cases days they will bring losses that are higher than -2.56% for an optimal Sharpe portfolio. And if you take average of these losses, it will be -4%. You can improve this average of losses and optimize your portfolio to reduce this average of bad losses from -4% to -3%, but you will lose some of the expected annual return, and this will be a big loss because you are losing from 22% in case of a Sharpe ratio to 15.8% for a optimal cVAR portfolio. But it's up to you whether you want to risk more and choose a max Sharpe portfolio, or you want to reduce volatility and reduce conditional variance for a portfolio to build a highly protective case. Now we will talk about the efficient frontier. You will see these 8 points on the chart. Each point represents one stock, you will see returns and volatility on axis. So if you're a risky investor, you don't need to make an optimal portfolio. You can just simply choose a maximum return stock, Nvidia in this case, or you can choose a maximum return alternative investment as Bitcoin and go all in. But you know that over the long term, this is a very risky strategy, and that's why we want to see hedging in our portfolio, and we are trying to mix in other stocks. So if you're adding other stocks from these eight, we will see later that any combination of stocks will deliver some point under this line, which is called an efficient frontier. It is a convex area, and any point specifically on this line will be a point on an efficient frontier. So this optimal selection point is a maximum Sharpe ratio point when the tangent curve is optimal on this line. But you can select any other point depending on your risk return profile. So let's try to get this efficient frontier. We are doing simulations, and we're building 10,000 of portfolios with various weight splits between stocks with Dirichlet random distribution. And if you put all lines from the simulation, or all points from the simulation, you will get this area. So you can approximately understand that there will be a frontier for this area, and it's always better to select higher return stocks with a given high return combinations or high return portfolio with a given volatility. Say you have 15% volatility in your portfolio, so you're ready to risk 15% of your money. You will definitely want to choose a portfolio that will deliver you approximately 30% of returns, highest possible points. And that's why you want to select a point on this efficient frontier. So last piece of analysis is a discrete allocation. Let's check why do we need this. We take last date prices and we take the maximum Sharpe ratio weights. If you multiply prices on weights, you will see that you need to buy specifically this amount of stocks if you have in total just $2,000. And many numbers are not close to the discrete number of stocks, like 0.48 for a Shopify stock. So Shopify stock stock's price now is almost $1,500. If you can buy only discrete number of stocks, you can't buy 0.48. You will need to buy at least one stock of Shopify, and you will spend $1,500 out of $2,000. That is almost all money that you have. That's why there is another function which is called a discrete allocation method, which will find you an optimal portfolio which is close on metrics to the max Sharpe or another optimal portfolio line on the efficient frontier, but this portfolio will have only discrete amount of stocks to buy. And this restriction is often imposed by many brokers, and you can't buy fractional shares, but sometimes you can buy, and it can be an important factor to think about when you choose your own broker. Thanks for watching, and let me remind you once again that there is a very detailed article on the portfolio optimization that I wrote by myself, where you can try to get these portfolio metrics, do the simulation, and come up with the best performing portfolio with your own hands, and not just call the methods from the standard library and not understanding how they actually calculate all those numbers. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.